Penguin presents Deep Sea Dive, a Ladybird audio adventure, read by Sophie Aldred.
Chapter 1. On the Seashore.
Hello, fellow travellers. I'm planning a journey. Would you like to come? We're going to explore the oceans of the world. Yes, all of them. Oh, sorry. Let me introduce myself and my friend here. I'm Cassandra, and this is Missy the Raven. Say hello, Missy. We've travelled far and wide together, but we've never been beneath the waves. Shall we change that today? Excellent. We're on the beach now. You can hear the waves crashing against the rocks. I love everything about the beach. The smell of the salt and seaweed, and all the different shades of blue and green. It just makes you want to dive in. There's a lot of it to dive into, too. Over 70% of the surface of our planet is covered in water. There are five enormous oceans on Earth, and they are all home to lots of different animals and plants. Why would someone want to live underwater? I think fish would say the same about living on land.
It's all so dry and cold and bright up there, they'd say.
Yeah, okay. That wasn't a very good fish impression. How about we go and meet some real fish instead? Fancy a trip to see what life is like underwater? Well, yes, we would get wet if we just jumped in. But I have an idea that might keep us dry. You know how I love inventing? Well, I've built an extra special machine that can float in water, travel between different oceans in the blink of an eye, and dive down deep into the sea. It's like a submarine that can also cross huge distances in an instant. I call it the Water Strider. What's a submarine? Oh dear, I'm leaping ahead of myself, aren't I? That happens when you have a busy brain like mine. A submarine is a special type of boat that can travel under the water as well as on top of it. Are you ready to dive? Then let's climb inside the Water Strider. Now we're going to drive into the water. Then I'll press this and hopefully it'll work. Oh. Sorry, I meant to say it is definitely going to work. I just can't wait to see it in action. All of my inventions work. That teleporter was one of my very early inventions. And I managed to get my nose back into the right place on my face eventually. Well, anyway, this is my latest and greatest invention. And it will absolutely, definitely, cross my heart, work. Let's roll! See? We're safely underwater. Oh, look! A fish! Oh, no, wait. It's a plastic bottle. I wish people wouldn't dump rubbish in the oceans. It's so sad and unnecessary. Would you press that button for me? That should take us to the middle of the biggest ocean in the world, the Pacific. Okay, ready? 3, 2, 1, go!
Chapter 2. Where the sun still shines.
All right! Here we are! The Water Strider's onboard computer says we're in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, a couple of hundred kilometres from the coast of Japan. We're on the surface now, so let's dive down to see... What? You saw something jump out of the water? Where? Oh, yes! I see it now. That's a spinner dolphin. There it is again. Spinner dolphins are famous acrobats. They love to jump and dive and... Can you guess what else? No, not tap dance. They love to spin. Other species of dolphin don't really spin. I imagine because it causes dizziness. But spinner dolphins are expert spinners. No, they're not squealing. They're whistling to each other and clicking. They're very different sounds to the songs you birds sing. Dolphins make two different kinds of sound. When they're chatting with each other, talking about the temperature of the sea and so on, they make a whistling sound. But when they want to find out where they are, or what might be in their way, they use clicks. The clicking is called echolocation. Dolphins make a noise and then listen. If the noise bounces back to them as an echo, they know that an object is in front of them and they swim out of the way. What clever fish, you say? Well, dolphins are not fish. Dolphins are animals called mammals. I'm a mammal, and so are dogs and cats and sheep and kangaroos. I don't know. What do you get if you cross a kangaroo with a sheep?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.